Do you treasure him? Do you delight in him? Or are you grieving him? Or are you quenching him? If you feel distance from the Lord, if you feel like you're just, your prayers are bouncing off the ceiling, and some of you people think it's the devil, honey, it's get on your face and say, Lord, did I offend you in any way? He'll show you. He wants you to come to him.
Amen.
And he wants to embrace you. He wants to pour out his love to you. I'm going to play my final song. And if there's anybody here who is moved by the song, that wants to come down the altar, feel free to. They're open. If you just want to sing, if you don't want to sing, if you just want to listen, that's fine too. And this will be our closing time.
Talking about what his heart, all the speakers today were talking about, it was in their heart. Louene was talking about what's in her heart, And they're all letting God be God, talking about how he can be God, how he is God. Isn't that amazing? None of us can ever, we're never going to arrive. That's the most exciting, catch what I'm saying. We'll never arrive. If we did, we'd be with him. But in the meantime, until we're assimilated in with him, we're still going to have things to seek after, things he wants us to do. You understand what I'm saying? It'll never, never, never get old. You'll never be tired of seeking the Lord the way he's got it set up. Everything else you've ever sought after, you got tired of. It let you down, but not God. And I can just picture, because she tells me all the time where her heart is, how we offend him. And that's her thing. And me, I understand that, but I'm doing the best I can, you know. I mean, that's not where I see him as. I see him as something he's putting in my heart to go help other people to get to know him. Evangelism. Then he'll send teachers to build us. You understand what I'm saying? So if we would just simply, and there's not a whole lot we can do except be willing. There's a word right there. Simply be willing to do what he wants you to do. How many is willing to let God be God? Just willing. Now, if you're not, you don't raise your hand. You know in your heart. And that's what she's talking about. If you don't, you're kidding yourself. You're playing with God. Like she said, you're making an idol out of your relationship with the Lord. You can't do that. It won't work. I'm sure there's people that have been in church all their life. Haven't got a clue who God is. They feel like they've been ripped off because they didn't get a chance to do what other people did. Some of the rest of us have been in jail and prison and really... We said we wish we had not been there. But that's neither here nor there. Where we've been, where we haven't been, it's where we are now. And what are we going to do with God? Are we willing? Simply willing. Pray with me. Say, dear God, I know what I need to do. Is just let you have your way. I am willing. I want to be willing. I want to give it all to you. I'm tired of me trying to run my life. So as you're dealing with me this week, Lord, help me become willing. Because I want to give it all to you. I want to grow in your grace and knowledge for your will, not mine. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. All right, get a good night's sleep. Tomorrow we'll get up. But by the way, we still got an hour tomorrow. I get to preach at Calvary tomorrow. 7 to 8. Robert, what's the time? Robert will be there. I don't think the Wonder will be there, but Robert will be there. And then we'll be here at 9 o'clock and get him again. Let God be God. God bless you. Have a good one.
Next time.
Yes! Now you get.
Hey, somebody forgot their hat! Blue one! I'm going to help
still riding the bus.
Yeah, leave the stuff like it is, man. They leave the open.
Lord knows what happened to the dog.